Hi, we have a young pretty girl here who has undergone face makeover. This is how she was on side view. One of the main concerns she had was that she had a longish face, her upper jaw was retruded inside, and her lower jaw had come arched out. You can see this. This was the length of the face, and this was the width of the face. Now, we also got the scans done for her. You can have a look at the scan straight away. This is the scan. You see, this is the one before. Now, if you see, this is the length of the face in the pre-op. And interestingly, she had her surgery done at another hospital some years ago where they tried to put a lot of implants, but then the desired result was not achieved. And what you see now is just 1 week after the major surgery that we've done. And this is 7 weeks post-op, the pre-op, which I showed you to what she's right now. And this is the pre-operative view. You can see how many implants are there in the upper and the lower jaw and the length of the face. This is after I've done the corrective procedure. And you can see her very clearly the length of the face has been reduced and the projection has been increased. So the work has happened on the angle. So that we've done surgeries here on the angle, done surgery on the chin, removed the earlier implants, this protrusion here, and also on the side. So we've given her a nice profile. And we've also given the correct ratio. So one of the most important things in facial aesthetics is, yes, symmetry, but also the golden ratio. The proportion has to be perfect and the projection has to be good as well. So all of these things are today's side effect, and we can alter that with the help of complicated but very, very precise maxillofacial and craniofacial surgeries. So we're happy that she was there with us for so long. If we're waiting, Linda. Okay. So she doesn't have any pain, she says, and this is day 7. A lot of our patients are not feeling totally comfortable after a major surgery like this for even as long as a month, because the recovery is a bit too long for some of these surgeries when you work on all the jaws. I'm going to show you some of the other views of her now. Let me just get this right there. So you see, this is her side view, and some of the other pre-operative views. That's her front view. You can see the hollowness, the severe nasolabial grooving. Also, it gives her an older look, as if she aged more. Now we have a face that looks much more fuller, much more younger, much more angular. And the most important, we've gotten rid of the implants that the earlier surgeon had done in order to try and correct it. So this was a revision surgery. And going from here to where she's now in just a few days. And that's all the pictures from the pre-op. I think you can also see the view from the basal view where we've got that corrected. This is like a hollowing going in the mid-face. And I've also got the orthochitomogram for her. So we've got the pre-op and the post-op. I'm going to show you the comparison now. So this is the pre-op, the one on the right, and the one on the left is the post-op. So you can see that there's been a lot of movement that's happened on the bones, and we also removed a lot of these implants. So this is a type of face makeover surgery that we do here at Richardson's very often. Our goal is to take care of the face as a whole. We don't deal just with the teeth, we don't deal just with jaws, we don't do just the soft tissue work or just the hard tissue work. So the face is made up of bones, cartilage, muscles, and skin and mucosa and everything. So we want to give a comprehensive, total care and result for our patients. And I like to keep saying this, but we take care of our patients' faces more than anyone else. Thank you.